Hi everyone, welcome to your lab on the Aldol reaction. In today's lab, we will be carrying out a solventless Aldol reaction, which is highly desirable for green chemistry considerations. Let's go! Before we start, please make sure to wear your goggles, mask, and gloves. Also, take proper precautions so as to not come into direct contact with sodium hydroxide or the reaction mixture that you will make. In an aldol reaction, it is important to identify the alpha carbons. Protons on the alpha carbon are more acidic and react with a strong base like sodium hydroxide to form a base that can be stabilized via resonance. However, the base that is formed can also act as a strong nucleophile and react with the compound containing the aldehyde. The resulting compound then reacts with an acid to give the aldol product in water. However, using an aldehyde with hydrogens on the alpha carbon tends to generate multiple products. And it's for this reason that you'll be using an aldehyde without hydrogens on the alpha carbon and coupling it with a ketone. The term solventless mentioned previously stems from the fact that the mixture of these two compounds has a melting point below room temperature. The reaction will be carried out by combining 3,4-dimethoxybenzaldehyde and 1-indinone with sodium hydroxide. Hydrochloric acid will then be added to neutralize and further acidify the reaction mixture. Then, you will isolate the solid via vacuum filtration and recrystallize from hot 9:1 ethanol water volume per volume solvent. Finally, you will determine your product using IR spectroscopy. To start this experiment, put 0.25 grams of 3,4-dimethoxybenzaldehyde and 0.20 grams of 1-indinone into a vial or test tube. Use a glass rod to scrape, crush, and combine the solids together until they become a brown oil. Place about 40 to 50 milligrams of sodium hydroxide between two sheets of whey paper and crush with a pestle. Carefully transfer the sodium hydroxide into the vial or test tube and continue to scrape until the oily mixture forms a solid. Let the mixture sit for 15 minutes. After the 15 minutes, add 2 milliliters of 10% aqueous hydrochloric acid to neutralize and further acidify the reaction mixture. Check the pH of the solution to make sure that it is acidic. Collect the crude product via vacuum filtration in preparation for recrystallization. First, weigh the crude product. Transfer the crude product into an Erlenmeyer flask and heat your 9:10 ethanol water solvent in a separate Erlenmeyer flask equipped with a boiling chip on a heating mantle. It is important to use an Erlenmeyer flask as its small neck reduces the amount of solvent evaporated into the air. When the solvent is almost boiling, transfer a minimum hot solvent into the flask with the crude product and mix to dissolve as much solid as possible. Heat the ethanol and solid mixture until a gentle boil, stirring it frequently. While you are waiting for the mixture to boil, fold a large piece of filter paper as shown. This is a fan-folded fluted filter paper. This will be used as your filter for hot filtration. To set up the hot filtration, place a short stem funnel in a clean 50 milliliter Erlenmeyer flask. put the fluted filter paper into the funnel. There should be a space between the filter paper and funnel so as to relieve pressure built up during heating. Once the mixture is mostly dissolved and has been kept at a gentle boil, prime the filter paper with a few drops of hot solvent. Transfer the mixture into the filter paper. Wash the flask with hot solvent. Only wash 1 to 2 times, as too much solvent will result in poor recovery of your product. Make sure to keep the hot filtration on the heating mantle at a gentle boil and allow all solvent to be filtered into the flask. Once hot filtration is complete, remove the flask from the heating mantle to begin the recrystallization process. To recrystallize properly, you will need to slowly cool down your solution to room temperature. This should take about 15 minutes or so. You should be able to see the crystals slowly form. Once at room temperature, transfer your flask into an ice bath to continue the recrystallization process. Once the precipitate has formed, isolate the product via vacuum filtration and keep the vacuum on to facilitate drying. Identify your product using melting point and IR spectroscopy. And that's it. I hope this video helped with your understanding of the Aldol reaction.